So I'll be talking about this software called Grafana Loki, which my colleagues at Grafana have built this. And it's like Prometheus, but for logs. But you will see why we call that. Before we start, a little about myself. I'm a software engineer at Grafana Labs, and I'm a Prometheus maintainer. And I just graduated this year with bachelor's, and yeah, this is my first gig. Yeah, so a few questions. Who uses Prometheus here? Can I get a raise of hands? Yeah. And if you're, and Grafana? Okay, that's nice. And Kubernetes? Kubernetes? Okay. Yep, thank you. Yep, so a little history about Loki. The project started last year in March, and after a lot of development privately, we officially launched it at KubeCon North America last year in December. And yeah, since then, the development has been rapid, the growth has been rapid, and we had the first 0.1 release recently. Okay, that's 0.1 and not 1.0. And right now we are at 0.4 release. Yeah, this is just, and there is a design doc which was floated 1.5 years ago. But yeah, I'm not going much into the history, but let's see what we have. So I'm going to focus on these three main points of Loki. Loki is basically a log aggregation system, and these three points will define why Loki is different than existing log aggregation system and why would you want to use Loki. So let's first start with the point simple to scale, how Loki is simple to scale. Before I talk about Loki, let's see how existing log aggregation system works. Currently, if you have a log which has like a time, job, environment, or line, etc., and it has a log ID. And when you want to index it, you'll usually index all the thing that's there in the log, like time, job, and the line is broken down into its tokens and they're indexed. So one problem with this is the labels are of very high cardinality, and we know if the stuff is very high cardinality, it's difficult to index, and if it's difficult to, it's very complex to manage. And if you index like this, your index size becomes comparable to your log data, which is again huge. And yeah, and because of the such indexing, if you have multiple nodes on which your log aggregation system is running, because of the high cardinality, the logs coming from a single stream, from a single process, is highly likely it's going to touch all the nodes. So if you want to fetch logs from a single service, you're probably going to touch all the nodes, and that's difficult to scale if you have a very huge system. So here comes Prometheus. In Prometheus, we group logs into something called streams. All the logs which are coming from a single process and a single pipe, like STD error or STD out, those are grouped into a single stream, and it's given a metadata like job equals frontend environment, and it can give multiple metadata for that stream, and those are grouped into time index chunks. So even if you have like billions of log lines, there will be just like few thousand entries in the index. And the one advantage of doing full indexing, like we saw before, is that it gives richer queries and fast queries. But the idea with Loki is you just index the metadata and you fetch the logs using the metadata, and whatever filtering you do after that is like brute force grep. And because we have all the logs of a single stream together in a time-bound chunks, we can also compress it well. And the index, because of these streams, the index doesn't grow with increase in number of log lines. So yep, that makes it easy to scale, because if you take this diagram, all the logs coming from a single stream will be going to a single node. And when you want to fetch logs from a single stream, you're going to touch only that node. And now talking about integration with existing observability tools. For example, if you want to currently debug an alert, like you get paged, and then you look at the dashboards, what's not going right, and then probably you will fiddle with some of the monitoring tools and the queries in your dashboard, and yeah, and that would follow a single query language. But when you want to shift like you found out which service is giving problem in this monitoring tool, and then you want to check the logs. What you'd usually do is you have to translate all the language that you use for monitoring tools into the language that the log aggregation system would use. So there is a big context switch when you're shifting from metrics to log aggregation systems currently. And then again, if you want to go from logs to tracing, there is again a context switch. And this context switch costs a lot. So by the time you reach from alert through all this process and then to the fix, a lot of time is spent in switching the context between different observatory tools. So before talking about Loki, why we'll see it's like Prometheus. The way Prometheus stores data is there is an identifier. The identifier is just a bunch of label values. And it points to time series, which is time and value on the, just a list of time and value. So this is how Prometheus stores. Whenever you want to fetch a particular time series, you just point it to that label and that value, and all the series matching to that label values will be fetched. Like another point about Prometheus is how it integrates with Kubernetes and how labeling works. Prometheus, when it comes up, it talks to a service SQL like DNS, and from there it fetches all the targets that it has to monitor, and it also fetches some of the metadata like the namespaces and the instance IP, all those. So when you and from there you get to know which services you have to monitor. And when you are monitoring the service, the Prometheus, when it's monitoring, when it fetches the metric, it attaches the metadata that it got from the service discovery to those metrics. So that's the part about Prometheus here. And looking at how Loki stores the data, it looks very similar to the previous slide that I showed. It also stores in the way like identifier and time and value. Here the identifier are again label values just like Prometheus. And the value here, the value in Prometheus was a float number, but here it's a string which consists the log line. And just like Prometheus, we have a job called prompt tail. So it asks Kubernetes or whatever service discovery that you're using what services we want to collect logs from. And we get some meta information like the job, service name, and other stuff. And then after we have got all those info, we tail the log files in the services. And when it's fetching the logs, it again attaches the same meta data that Prometheus attached to the metrics. The Loki, the prompt tail will attach those metadata to the logs and push it to the Loki. That's why whenever you are looking at the metrics, like here you have job, level, and type, and the same label names are there for the metrics. Left side is the Prometheus, right side is the Loki. This, I will be showing a demo later. And coming back to the same picture, you are at the dashboard, you queried the metrics, and you got to know which services are not performing well, and you know the label values from the Prometheus, and you use the same label values in the log to fetch the logs. So there's no context switch when you're coming from metric space to the log space. And yeah, tracing is one more thing remaining, but that will be tackled later mostly. So the time you get from alert to the fix is drastically reduced by reducing the complexity between these two. Yep, so we talked about how simple it is to scale and how it integrates with the monitoring and the log aggregation system. So we'll talk how it's airplane friendly and cloud native. Why I call it airplane friendly is like you can run Loki on a system without needing any external dependencies. So that's why I call it airplane friendly. You can just run a Loki instance on a laptop, which I'm going to do for the demo, which I'm going to show at the end. And because it's cloud native, because you can containerize the Loki, and you can use Cassandra, Bigtable, or many data stores to store the logs. And talking about scaling out, there is a single binary to run the Loki. And if you want to scale out, use the same binary and just scale out Loki. Run a bunch of Loki instances, and it uses gossip among themselves and just scales out nicely. But when you're scaling out, you might have to use a persistent store because the storing data in the local storage is not implemented for scaling out. So you want to use a persistent store to store data when you scale out. Additionally, you can also run this as a microservice oriented using the same binary, like all the small components that you see is the small Loki binary. So this architecture is originally inspired from another software called Cortex. Cortex is a horizontally scalable multi-tenant Prometheus implementation. So Loki actually just renders most of the code from the Cortex, and wherever there is a time series with time and value, just replaced with the logs and just worked out. Yeah. Just to give you an example at how much scale it can run, currently we are running Loki, which you can sign up on grafana.com and play with it. We are receiving like 9.5 billion logs per day, which takes about 1.5 terabytes. So with this architecture, we are able to handle those many logs currently, and which will obviously going to grow. Yep. So we talked about these 3 points, and there's one bonus which comes with the Loki is that you can use Loki as a Prometheus data source. If you're wondering how, I'll be showing in the demo right now. Yep. So I have already run a bunch of these stuff to build locates. Ignore this path variables, it's just some mess in my laptop. You have to just to make Loki and you will get the Loki binary. And to run it locally, there is already a config file provided with the distribution. Yep, like it's already there, you can use this config file as it is. Yep, it's in Grafana Loki. When you build, it's in CMD and Loki. Like, are you following what I'm saying? Yep, okay. Yep, so I'm already running Loki here. Like, I just ran it 15 minutes ago so that I can have some data before I show you. And that was as simple as running the binary file with the config file that I just showed you. And additionally, I am running a dummy logger, which my colleague Cyril from Grafana built it, which will just push some random logs to this Loki instance. And I'm running Grafana 6.4.3, which is the latest, I guess. And we'll be adding Loki as a data source. And let's jump into that. So I have already added two data sources in Grafana. One is Loki, which just points to localhost 3100. And there is a Loki, I call it Loki Prometheus because it points to the same instance, which is the Loki instance with an addition of slash Loki. Is everyone able to see at the back what I'm showing here? Okay. Yep. So now let's query some stuff. I think I have to turn off the Wi-Fi for this to work. I don't know why. Yep, now we have this. I'll just choose some component backend, and yeah, I have some logs here. Because we have logs here, I'll just focus on this part. These are just some random logs. So in Prometheus, you usually query, you'll usually query using the label values, and it's the same way that you query here. And if you wanted to just grep on that, you just have something like chicken. Yeah, chicken died during the process. Yeah, it's a logger that my colleague created. Yeah, and this is a equality matcher. Then you, if you want to do like regex, you just have like this. Yep, regex and regex not equal to, and this is not equal to something like that. And it's not just a single pipe, you can have it's a regex match, sorry, and then yep, error while reading floppy disk. So yeah, these are just few examples. And some more stuff. If I just enable labels here, I can just look at the stats, like what's the percentage of errors, info and debug, go on. It'll disappear. And also you can live tail a query. So for component backend, these are the logs that are appearing right now. I can just pause or exit live mode. What else do I want to show here? Yeah, this is about Loki. Now let's switch to Prometheus. Like we'll just copy this component is backend. I can add, yeah, for example, I can have level equals to error and it will filter based on that. Now switching to Prometheus, I can have component backend, but let's have something like count over time for the past 1 minute. Yeah, that's a lot of them. So I'll just pick level equals to error. Yeah, there are multiple services for which these are the error counts of error, and if you want the rate of error, like how many errors are happening per second, this is the one. And we can do aggregation on this, like I want to see what's the total rate of errors, total rate of logs grouped by their level. So I will choose rate for regex all of them for past 1 minute, like the average of past 1 minute, and get a sum of that by level. And yep, you can, yeah, that's it. Like this is the rate per second, it's 2 or something like that. But if you want to filter for some component like we saw, for this component, the rate of logs is this. Yeah. So that's how Prometheus Loki can work as a Prometheus data source. Let me just check once if I had to show something more. Yep, that's all. Thank you.
Are there any questions?
That means either it was very good or very bad. Yep. Like okay. If you want to ask any questions, I'll be around. You can just grab me later. And if you want Grafana or Prometheus stickers or Loki stickers, catch me later.
Thank you.